Success or failures of different societies depend on the degree of economic inequality because it directly affects the well-being of their citizens. My name is Conchita D'Ambrosio. I'm an economist working at the University of Luxembourg, and I work on individual and social well-being and their determinants.
In modern societies, the well-being of people depends on many factors, including economic inequality, poverty, and insecurity. Even in a rich country, people with a regular income and a decent standard of living can have a low level of well-being and a feeling of economic insecurity.
Economic insecurity is the anxiety you have today that you are hit by an economic shock in the future and you're not able to make it.
Conchita D'Ambrosio has been studying the determinants of inequality and economic insecurity and their effects on individual behavior and well-being by analyzing large data sets of individuals observed over many decades in several countries, including Australia, Germany, and the UK.
Observing individuals for many years, our preliminary results show that the more insecure individuals have, it's more likely that they go and vote for the right-wing parties. Some other projects is to see if these worries transmit from parents to children. And in our data, we find that the major financial problems during the weeks of pregnancy produce smaller kids in terms of weight and both in terms of the head circumference. The effects are 30% of the size of smoking and drinking, so they really have an impact on the quality of life of individuals.
Results with direct political implications. Therefore, an important part of Conchita D'Ambrosio's work is to directly get in touch with policymakers and representatives from the Luxembourg government and European institutions to present the results of her scientific analysis. One initiative in this direction is a lecture series open to everybody. Since 2013, internationally renowned guest speakers have presented their work on many different topics related to inequality and well-being. The events are held at the European Investment Bank, and many people from civil society attend, including government representatives and experts from EU institutions.
We are the biggest multilateral financial institution in the world, and our daily work is informed by the latest research findings. Inequality is the biggest challenge that policymakers will face the next decades. It's already partially so. And working with university to organize these inequality series of seminars is very important for the bank. The work with Professor Conchita D'Ambrosio, this cooperation, it's a way of bringing the knowledge to those that will improve people's lives.
To be a sustainable and successful society, not only in the short run, individual and social well-being have to be constantly monitored. Even in comparatively wealthier societies, individuals worry about their economic future, and as a consequence, economic insecurity is growing.
We know that poor people are less healthy. This is not a novelty of what we're saying. What we are saying, and with my team, is that with the double dip recession, the new thing is not what's happening to the poor, it's what's happening to the middle class. It's them that are worried. It's the middle class that is economically insecure. So this is the new thing, is that we will have the majority of the population that feel insecure.
Measuring well-being statistically and scientifically is an enormous challenge. Together with sociologists and psychologists, Conchita D'Ambrosio analyzes large amounts of data on individuals that contain information on standard economic factors, such as their income, wages and wealth, but also on other aspects of their life, such as marital and employment status, number of children, physical and mental health, and education. But objective aspects of one's life alone are not enough.
In my work, we also use answers individuals give when they're asked about their level of well-being, like how satisfied you are with your life in general, question on the quality of their sleep, anxiety days they had in the past. And then I see if the measures we propose theoretically are correlated, are able to explain the answers people give.
By using sophisticated formulas and algorithms, Conchita D'Ambrosio and her team combine statistical facts with individual sentiments and psychological phenomena. By transforming them into numbers and making them calculable, they can find interesting correlations and changes over time that can capture well-being in a society.
Life satisfaction does not depend only on your level of income, but depends on your wishes. And the wishes are formed on what you see around, what you see on TV, what you think you could have, what you think you should have because of your level of education, because of the way you were brought up. So the more you think you should have and you do not have, the less satisfied you are with your life, independently of what you have. It's the gap that matters.
Through the FNR PEARL grant, Conchita D'Ambrosio has managed to establish a team of experts at the University of Luxembourg addressing one of the most relevant societal topics, the well-being of its citizens.
The grant allowed me to build a team of young and very interested researchers. The PEARL brought me here and I'm going to stay.
A good example of applied social sciences that not only Luxembourg, but also other countries can benefit from.